Hello dear students, hope all of you are doing very well at home. Exam periodic 1 is just above the head. I know you people are preparing and you have different questions in your mind regarding the exam and the pattern of exam, many more things. Leave all those and just see this video. Dear students, this video I am preparing on the date 17-7-2020, and this is for class 10th. Topic is control and coordination. Let's begin. Dear students, you just studied the nervous system in human beings and how nervous system works in human beings, how many types are they have and what are the mechanism of working. Similarly, in same sequence you studied about the chemical coordination in animals also. Dear students, in plants, the control and coordination is not as elaborate as in animals. Do you know? It is because plants do not have the nervous system. Muscle cells are sense organs like eyes, ear, nose. Okay. Still they are able to respond to the changes in the environment, like gravity, water, temperature, light, chemicals, etc. Have you ever think plants do not have the nervous system? They do not have the sense organs? Then how they respond to the changes in the environment? How they coordinate their behavior to a stimuli? It is because of plant hormones. This is also called phytohormones. Plants do not have the nervous system, so they do not get the information regarding the changes in the environment quickly, and they are also not able to respond quickly because they do not have the nervous system. But still they respond, but at slower rate. And what type of response they show? How this response has come? So like animals, there is some kind of movement in the response of the changes in the environment. Similar in plants also. Plant also show movements in response to the stimuli, whether the stimuli is external or internal, as in case of animals. But only one thing, that they do not have the nervous system, so their response is slow and it is not visible immediately. Okay. It can be observed by watching the plant for somewhat longer time. Then we are able to get the information about their response to the changes in the environment. How this change happens? This change happens because of the chemical coordination, means chemicals, phytohormones, plant hormones that are synthesized and secreted by the plants. And how these hormones work? If they do not have the nervous system, they do not have a proper system of digestion and supply. They have, but it is simple. Okay. The plant hormones act in two ways in the plants. The first hormones, how works, how they bring the change in movement. The first effect in the growth of plant organs. Okay, by affecting the growth of plant organs. You can take the example of a germinating seed. The seed is of different shape and it will germinate, it develop its root, its shoot system. This is because of the influence of hormone and it is a kind of growth movement. Okay, towards the sunlight the leaf rises, towards the water inside the soil, towards the dark root will rise. Okay, second is affecting the shape of cells by changing water balance or pressure, amount of water in them. What kind? What is the name of that pressure? Turgor pressure. Okay? Turgor. By affecting the turgor. Means amount of water will either reduce or increase. Either the cell will shrink or cell will swell by changing the amount of water in it. For example, you can take here the plant of touch me not. Okay. This shrinks by touching, because by changing the amount of water in the cells, you will study later. Okay. So these are the two actions of hormone, how they coordinate the behavior of plant to the environment. Okay. These two changes. Now, let's know what kind of movement shown by the plants. Okay? Plants movement. There are two types of movement shown by the plant in response to the stimuli. One is called the gnostic movement. And second is called the trophic movement. Okay. These two kinds of movements shown by the plants in response to the stimuli. Let's begin it. Gnostic movements. Gnostic movements are the induced movement, and because plant, especially higher plants, remain fixed to the substrate and they do not move from one place to another, so the movement by the change in the orientation of their organs. Means this type of movements are not related to growth. Okay? Growth independent movement. Which kind of movement is it? Growth independent. Means it does not affect on. Okay? And it is non-directional also. It is non-directional. Okay. Now, this has the two types, this type of movement has two types. One is the nifty nasty. And this nifty nasty in the plants, they change their orientation, they move their organs by changing by directional time, means day to night, 24 hour cycle. Okay, means in daytime the organ will be in different orientation exposure, and during night time their organs or their parts will be in different orientation. Parts like the leaves, flowers, these are okay. Let's take here the example. Here this nifty nasty can be also taken as the, it is also called the sleep movement. Which kind of sleep movement? There are different types of plants. You can take the example of amla tree. Okay, the leaves of the amla tree at night attached together, collected together, and it seems that the whole leaf has been wilting in night. But when the in the morning, the leaf slowly spread out and it become normal. Okay, so this is the sleep movement types. Gold mohar is also an example. You can see that plant also. So this nifty nasty can be the photo nasty. Photo nasty and chemo nasty. This is in response to light, just like the blooming of dandelion flower in the morning and closing at evening when sunlight disappears. Okay, photo means light. So this type of, second type of movement in plant is seismonastic movement. Seismonastic. Seismonasty. What kind of movement is seismonasty? It is also called thigmonasty. Thigmonasty. Perhaps you have learned the example of touch me not plant. Which plant? Touch me not. Chui me. Chui. It is a plant of Mimosa family, Mimosa pudica. Okay, so this plant, when we touch the plant from any direction, the leaves shrink, bow down in downward direction. Okay, so this is non-directional, means from any direction you will touch, the movement is always same. So this is two types of plant movement, nastic movement and trophic movement. This nastic movement has two types, nifty nasty and seismonasty. Okay, this nifty nasty means night sleep, can be photonasty, chemonasty of many types. Okay, so this is all about this nastic movement for your class. We will meet soon after the exam. Okay, till then watch the video again and again. Thank you very much.